You're listening to Believe It, the radio life story, the radiography of me, Richard Wilson. I want to start with a Tim Vine joke. It goes like this. I've just been in a once-in-a-lifetime holiday. I tell you what, never again. That made me realise I'd never had a once-in-a-lifetime holiday. So I asked my new best friend, Jos Vantyler, to help me plan one. Let's find a fabulous villa in a wonderful place.
Let's. Can I come?
Of course. Who else shall we invite?
Everyone.
Oh, that's a lot of people, Jos.
Isn't it? Let's go online and find a villa that says sleeps everyone.
What about sleeps four? That's a good number.
Okay, I'll compromise. Name a country.
You start.
France?
As soon as Jos said France, I heard music. Name me a country and I instantly hear music of the most cliched kind. I sat there as he named more countries.
Spain? Greece? Jamaica?
He went on like this for 10 or 12 countries until he got to...
Madagascar?
What is the music of Madagascar? I couldn't think of anything. And then it got worse.
The Seychelles?
I found myself thinking, the Seychelles sounds like a girl group. You know, Diana Ross and the Seychelles.
The Maldives. Polynesia.
And then I found myself thinking, how many frigging countries are there in the world? I had to make a decision. Italy.
Italy.
Italy. It's a marvellous moment when you finally decide where you want to go and head for your travel agent. These days, of course, your travel agent has a memory and sounds like this.
Calabria villas, Umbria villas, Tuscany villas, or Lombardy villas?
Yes. 2 hours later, we were still looking. Time to make another decision. Enough. We are going to the villa with the pool and the view of hills.
They've all got pools and hills.
Calm yourself. We saw it maybe an hour ago on Italian villa holidays.
You mean Italian holiday villas?
Possibly.
You sure it wasn't Villas Italiana?
I'm almost sure.
Okay. Was it Villa Messina, high on the hillside, outside of beautiful Sorrento?
Show me the images.
There.
I think that's what. Yes. Bedrooms, living room, bathrooms, hob.
Let's go for it. There's a free cancellation up to 30 days before departure.
You think we should cancel it?
We haven't booked it yet.
True.
Come on, look at those patio doors. They're patio-tastic.
Yes, let's book it.
You're not just saying that because you're exhausted from looking.
Of course, but I'm sure it'll be okay. Is it expensive?
Very.
Well, there you are. It's bound to be good.
Who should we invite then?
There's a folder on my desktop, address book.
Okay, I'll open that. Shall I start with A?
Do.
Dave Armstrong. Is he nice?
Yes, very nice. He's my pest control man.
Great. I'll check if the villa's got rats.
An hour later, we got to M. Of course, Stephen Mangan. And as the sun came up over northwest London, we reached W. Arabella Weir. I went to bed, a happy man. I was going to a country I love with people I love. I wanted to pay for everything. The flights, the villa, the patio doors. It was once in a lifetime. Why not? A few weeks before we were due to go, we gathered in my flat to celebrate.
Here's to you, Richard.
Yeah, what a treat.
My pleasure. One piece of bad news. Jos, will you deliver it?
Oh, thanks, Richard. Right, our flight's been cancelled.
Oh.
But don't worry, we're going on the same day, just earlier.
Oh, well, that's fine. What time?
7:10 a.m.
So we should get to Heathrow around 4:30, yes?
4, just to be safe.
I'll order a car to pick you both up.
No, don't do that. We'll make our own way.
Yeah, you've done enough.
Tell you what, get here at 3 and we'll all go to Heathrow from here.
Okay, so I'll set my alarm for 1:30, 1 to be safe.
Hardly worth going to bed, is it?
We should talk bedrooms.
Ooh.
Yes. Gather round the laptop, people.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Bedroom one.
Ooh.
Great. Bedroom two. Great.
Mm-hmm.
Bedroom three. Mm. Great. Bedroom four, small.
It's not that small. Or is the photo life size?
Oh, who's that?
That's Roberto. He manages the villa and lives next door.
He's not small. He's tall.
Why don't we decide on bedrooms when we get there?
Good idea. The sun will be shining and we'll have been up since one.
How does that help?
We'll be too tired to argue.
Nice.
Too tired to argue with whom?
Good question. Too tired to argue with Richard. He's the man.
Why don't we just draw lots?
That's good. Should we do it now?
No. Let's wait till we get there. It's the best bit of holiday, isn't it?
What is?
The anticipation.
Oh, too true. Well, I'm looking forward to drawing lots.
Me too, because you can't rehearse it, can you?
Mm.
OK, then. I'll shut the laptop down.
Right. We're all set. No one has a problem with flying, do they?
No, just landing.
Oh, too right. What are you going to hit when you're flying? Nothing. Clouds. But when you're landing, you can see the buildings and cars.
OK, travel is hell, but arrival makes up for it.
Well said, Stephen.
Thank you.
Here's to us all being here at 3 on the morning of July the 19th.
Yes, let's all go to hell together.
Beautiful.
Guarda il mare come bello.
That night, I couldn't sleep. I woke up at 3 in the morning and I made a decision. Then I woke up at 4 and made it again. It was the right decision. But I didn't want to tell them in advance. No, I wanted to surprise them. On the morning of July the 19th, the clock struck 3. And there they all were, ready for hell. Stephen and Arabella with their suitcases on wheels, and Jos with his backpack and guitar, because he's younger. How are we all feeling? Excited?
Excited but exhausted.
Oh, I hate getting up in the dark. I feel like a badger.
Oh, stand still.
What?
You've got a bit of shaving foam on your cheek. There.
Oh, Jesus, I shaved last night. That's been on my face for hours.
The last time I went to Heathrow, a woman asked for my autograph.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. And when I gave it to her, she complained.
Why?
Because she thought I was someone else.
Who?
I don't want to talk about it.
Why'd you mention it then?
I'm just passing the time till the cab arrives.
Oh, God, we haven't even got to Heathrow and we're fighting.
Right. She thought I was the woman who does the weather on Anglia News. Happy now?
She's gorgeous.
Oh, don't bluff it. You've never seen her.
He's just being nice.
Oh, and now you're siding with him, are you?
We're not going to Heathrow.
What? Why not? Oh, have they cancelled our flight again?
No, I've cancelled our flight. And the villa.
Oh,
so, what, there's no holiday?
There's a holiday, all right, but it's in England.
What brought this on?
Well, it's like Stephen said, travel is hell, so let's minimise it.
Where are we going then, Richard?
Oh, is it Dorset?
Nope.
Cornwall? Yorkshire?
Norfolk?
It's here.
Where?
Huh?
Here, in this flat, we're having a holiday here.
Here? We are? Oh, that's mad.
Maybe, but it's not hell. Look around you. No queues, no delays, no crashing into buildings. We're in the building already.
I just want to go to bed.
And you can. If you'd gone to Sorrento, you'd have to wait for hours for a kip.
Which bedroom am I in, or do we draw lots?
Well, there's 3. I should have the one I always have, and Arabella should have her own.
So I'm sharing with Jos?
Yes. It's the door next to the bathroom.
Thank you. I've got to say, this whole not Heathrow thing is a joy.
Told you.
Oh, I can just walk through that door. I don't have to put my mobile in a tray or take off my shoes.
You say that, but if we're sharing a bed, I'd quite like you to take off your shoes.
Oh, fair point.
And if we're staying here, I'd like to cook. Italian naturello.
Naturello?
Yeah, naturally means naturally. Naturello.
So, Italy came to North London. At lunchtime, devoid of jet lag, with no luggage lost, we sat round a table on my balcony overlooking Regent's Park and imagined we were in Sorrento. And Jos did indeed cook a perfect lunch.
I sourced all the food and drink from the local Italian suppliers.
Splendid.
The pasta's from Alexandro's Deli in the Finchley Road.
Mm. Oh, it's great, Jos. I love your pomodoro.
What a coincidence. I love my pomodoro too.
And the wine?
It's Falanghina from Vetrose.
Mm.
Ah, waitros. Not Aldi or Tesco. Well, maybe not Lidl.
Your accent's perfect, Arabella. I was hoping you'd teach me Italian on this holiday.
I was hoping the same thing.
Ah, well, I was hoping to have a holiday romance, so you don't always get what you want, do you?
Okay, okay. Let's accentuate the positive for Richard's sake.
Thank you.
What do you want from this holiday then, Richard?
I want you all to be happy.
Oh, that's so nice.
And I want to read Trainspotting because I never have.
Ah, you want to learn Scots.
Indeed. And can I just say, I'm so happy we're in northwest London. Who needs a villa in southern Italy when you can see Regent's Park?
Parco del Regente.
You notice the traffic after a while.
You don't notice the traffic after a while.
Sorry, my mistake.
Yeah. Oh, what's this? This for you, Richard?
Yes, I ordered a ping pong table for the living room.
There's a games room.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Oh, this holiday just gets better. I've had a snooze, a fat drunken lunch in the sun, and now there's ping pong. Who's up for the first game?
I'm mad for it.
Me too.
Oh, God, no. It's not going to be a competitive holiday,
No,
is
I don't
it?
Think so. No, because I'm going to win. Yes, I win.
That was a knock-up, Stephen.
What's your point?
Ready for the guided tour, everyone?
Sure. Jos can lose later.
Where are you taking us, Richard?
Oh, I'd like to go to the Sherlock Holmes Museum.
Yeah, me too. Baker Street. That's not far.
221B Baker Street. I've known that address since before Cumberbatch was born.
Funny to think there was a time before Cumberbatch was born. He's so everywhere.
I've never been either. If you live near a place, you don't go.
That's right. You need a holiday to make you go there.
Another time, maybe.
Oh, OK. Don't tell me. We're going to have a guided tour of your flat.
Very good, Arabella. We're going to relax and go nowhere. Follow me. Right, here we are.
You don't often get four people in a bathroom, do you?
Makes for a lovely acoustic.
Shall I get my guitar?
Go for it.
So, let's start with the bath. It's made from stone resin and it's got spherical feet.
Oh, adorable.
And wall-mounted taps in the middle, as you see.
Oh, that's good. You don't have to lean forward to adjust them. They're just there.
That's right. I'm enjoying this. No point being a tour guide if the tourists aren't responsive.
We so are. Tell us more.
Got any bath songs, Jos?
Yeah. Do some busking near the sites. That's very touristy.
Okay.
Like a bridge over troubled water.
Nah, it doesn't really work, does it? Bath water's not actually troubled.
It is if you agitate it.
Well, I'm not giving you my change.
Let's turn to my toilet.
Okay.
Looks
kind of Victorian.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely right, Jos. That's the look I was after.
The cistern's amazing.
Isn't it? Aluminium.
Do you know, I've been to this toilet hundreds of times and I've never once noticed the cistern.
That's because you're a woman.
What? You mean women don't notice things?
No, I think he means you sit with your back to it.
What, and you don't?
Not if I'm having a wee.
This is getting too technical.
Sorry.
The point is, if we were in Sorrento and we went on a guided tour of the Naples Art Museum, we'd see a Caravaggio.
And?
This toilet is like my Caravaggio. Do you know why?
It costs a fortune.
Precisely.
Well, it is beautiful, Richard. And it's better than a Caravaggio because... no one's going to break in and steal it.
Maybe I should alarm it.
Boo! Sorry, I was alarming the toilet.
Yeah, no, we got it. And we all thought it was stupid.
It's a holiday. I'm allowed to say and do stupid things.
Yeah, if it's Club 1830. This is Club... how old are you, Jos?
34.
Well, this is Club 3485.
I want to go to the toilet.
You're in the toilet, Jos.
No, I mean, I want
to... Oh, sorry, yeah, right.
We'll leave you, Jos.
Hold my guitar.
From the toilet, we went to the utility room. I showed them my antique vacuum cleaners, which don't work, but are part of my permanent collection. Then we went to the living room, the next stop on our tour of what Arabella called...
Museo di Riccardo.
I showed them a painting by my much-missed chum, Anthony Scher. It was just like being in a proper museum, so much so that Jos said...
What's the Italian for postcard, Arabella?
Cartolina.
I wish I could buy a cartolina of that painting.
It was a lovely remark, but as we found out over dinner, it had a bad effect on Stephen.
And to follow, veal parmigiano.
Oh, could this be a more Italian holiday?
Yes, we could be in Italy.
You okay, Stephen?
My son asked me to send him a postcard from Italy. He's never had a postcard in his life. Can you believe that?
If only he could put a stamp on an email.
And here I am near Baker Street. I'm living a lie.
That's a bit extreme.
That's him. That's my son, Frank.
Tell him you're in Sorrento. I'll open the window. Here. That could be Italian traffic.
No, it couldn't. Where's the anger? Where's the horns?
Arabella's started an Italian argument.
What, with myself?
Hi. You all right? What have you been up to?
Oh, ma che cazzo
Good.
Fai, cretino, l'ha fatto così?
I'm in a cafe in Sorrento. Yeah, I know.
Non mi fai le due corne a me.
It's an old Italian woman.
I'm not old.
Sorry, middle-aged Italian woman.
Some more black pepper.
Yeah, listen, my food's arrived. We'll speak another time. Love to everyone. Bye.
Bye. Ah, cazzo.
That's it, then.
What?
My whole family thinks I'm in Italy.
No wonder. Arabella was superb.
Wasn't she? I felt I was there in that Sorrento cafe with a mad Italian woman dressed in black, shouting at her son who's in the mafia, but scared of his mum.
Oh, bless you.
We're not in Italy, okay? Can we just stop pretending?
Stephen's right. It's too effortful. From now on, let's eat English. Joss.
Seriously, you want me to throw away my tiramisu?
Mix it with jam roly-poly?
Oh, great. Tiramipoli.
We're all getting stressed. That isn't right. Stephen, what would make you less stressed?
Ping pong?
You're kidding! That is the most stressful game in the world.
Not if you win.
That's right. I always feel relaxed when I win.
He duly beat Arabella 21-9.
Yes! Thank you, Arabella.
What, you thanking me for losing?
Then he beat Jos 21-12.
Woohoo! I am the champions! I am the champions!
This is you relax,
no,
is it?
Yeah, no time for losing.
Joss was right. Stephen was being a loudmouth alpha male. He wasn't relaxed, and neither were we. Now it was my turn to play him. While Arabella read and Joss strummed, I confronted him across the table. Somehow, I had to unsettle him.
Ready to knock up?
No, that's fine. Just a second.
What are you doing?
I'm pulling up a chair, Stephen. I'm 30 years older than you. You can't expect me to stand.
No, of course.
You serve. Just play your usual game.
Okay. That's not too fast, is it?
Don't speak.
Sorry.
My plan worked perfectly. Confronted by the aging me, Stephen was sweetness itself. He didn't even try to win the point. He just lobbed the ball gently back and forth. So relaxed did he become that he started humming. So I joined in. And so did the others. Now it really was the holiday of a lifetime. Everyone in harmony in that beautiful wellness retreat known as my flat. Then I hit the ball into the net. And we all stopped humming. One love to you, Stephen.
One love. That's what it felt like. I felt suffused with love for everyone.
It was transcendent, wasn't it?
That was ping pong yoga.
Are you going to get on with the game or what?
No, that's it. No more games. No more winners and losers.
Wow.
We carried on in that vein for days, Joss cooking and strumming, Stephen being calm, me reading train spotting. Arabella read The Great Gatsby, but sadly she didn't have a holiday romance with him. Then I realised something extraordinary. We hadn't been out.
Oh, my God, that's extraordinary.
Well, not really. I've been on loads of villa holidays where you get there and you just sit by the pool for days.
Or in our case, sit by the bathroom.
Come on, then. Where should we go?
It's beautiful out there. Let's just walk around Regent's Park.
No, I'm up for that.
Stephen?
Oh, it's my son.
Tell him a postcard takes days.
And you know, they often get lost.
No, it's not that son.
How many sons have you got?
Three.
Oof, no wonder you need a holiday.
Hi. What's occurring? Where are you? Oh, right. I thought that sounded like penguins. Oh, wow. So you'll be there again tomorrow. That's great. Well done. Yeah, bye. Bye. My family's in Regent's Park as we speak. They're at the zoo. I should be with them.
Stephen, you're on holiday. No guilt.
Exactly. You're away.
Yeah, 5 minutes away.
You better stay here then, in case they spot you.
Yeah.
We'll go again tomorrow. You can come then.
No, he and his brother have joined softball teams that play in Regent's Park most days.
Aww.
Sorry about that.
I'm afraid so. I'm in prison.
Well, the best way to get through prison is to dream big dreams.
Thanks for that. Arabella, what's the English for I dreamt I was in Italy?
I dreamt I was in Italy.
God, you're good.
Arabella, Jos and I had a lovely afternoon. We strolled round the park. Then we sneaked off to the Sherlock Holmes Museum. We didn't tell Stephen that, mind you. It would have only made him more upset. When we got back, he was nowhere to be seen. Stephen? Hello?
Maybe he's gone out.
Maybe he's asleep, dreaming.
Shall I knock on his door?
Jos, you do it. You're his roommate.
Okay.
Come in.
Hi. Sorry, am I interrupting?
Oh, no, I'm having a Zoom. Come and say hello. Oh. This is Roberto. Roberto, Jos.
Ciao, Jos.
Ciao, Roberto. Oh, my God, that's Villa Messina.
I wanted to know what it was like.
Momento, Roberto. Can the others join us?
Sure.
Richard, Arabella. Bella Sorrento.
Sì, bella Sorrento.
Bellissima Sorrento.
Stephen's on a Zoom with Roberto from the villa.
Ah, splendid. Hello, Roberto. I'm Richard. Sorry we didn't hire the villa. It looks beautiful.
And this is Arabella, Roberto.
Ciao, Arabella.
Ciao, Roberto. La villa sembra bellissima. Spero molto che noi ci si veni un giorno. Conosco Napoli molto bene, ma non sono mai andata a Sorrento.
Parli perfettamente l'italiano, Arabella. You speak perfect Italian, Arabella.
Wish I did.
Me too.
You are beautiful. Sei bellissima.
Sorry, who are you talking to?
You're too kind, Roberto, but I bet you say that to all the girls.
You are not a girl. You are a woman.
Listen, Roberto, I know I didn't hire the villa, but can I hire you?
You want to hire me? I don't understand.
I'd like you to teach these boys Italian.
Oh, that's a great idea.
I love it.
What do you say, Roberto?
Certo, my pleasure. But I don't need to teach Arabella, do I?
Nope. Well, there's always more to learn.
Roberto made all the difference. It was Zoom, Zoom, Zoom all day long. On some of the Zooms, it was Jos and Stephen.
Stephen, say after me. La popolazione di Sorrento...
La popolazione di Sorrento...
è 15.000.
È 15.000.
Now you, Jos.
La popolazione di Sorrento è 15.000.
Bravo, Jos.
Thank you. But Stephen's good too.
Oh, there's no competition here, Jos.
No, we just love each other.
Are you sick?
When their lessons were over, Arabella had her own private Zoom.
Is it okay if I speak English? It's good for me.
Of course.
Tell me, you always wear your hair up?
No, not always.
May I see with your hair down?
Of course. Momento.
Oh, I wish I could touch it. Is that wrong?
Nothing is wrong, Roberto.
Then there was me. I just sit in front of the screen watching Roberto clean the pool or repaint the patio doors. We didn't even speak. I simply enjoyed the feeling of being there without the hell of getting there. It was Jos who described it best as we sat there eating his classic English tandoor chicken takeaway. Mm.
It's the zoliday of a lifetime, isn't it?
What's a zoliday?
A Zoom holiday.
Exactly.
Ah. Oh, that's the future, isn't it? You can go anywhere and nowhere. Bella parola, Jos.
Which means nice word in Italian.
Yeah, I know.
I was telling Richard.
Do you want to hear some Scots? I finished train spotting this morning. It's a masterpiece.
Go on.
I stood in that rage in the din.
What's that mean, then?
I've no idea, but I know it's brilliant.
What about you, Arabella?
I just finished Gatsby. I mean, I've read it before, but...
Never mind that.
What?
We want to know if you and Roberto have had Zex.
What's Zex?
Oh, come on, even I know that. Zoom sex.
Okay, well, full disclosure... He's invited me to stay with him in Sorrento.
Hey, congratulations!
So when are you going?
I'm not. He's gorgeous and sweet and he's 34, which is all fantastic, but he lives with his mother. And frankly, who needs that?
So it's over before it's begun?
No, 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 you don't understand. It totally began and now it's totally over. And it was just perfect. There was no weeping at airports, no breaking up, no getting back together, no passion.
Yeah, who needs passion, eh?
Exactly. It's exhausting and repetitive and noisy. There was just a load of long-distance flirting, which made me feel great.
Well, here's to you then, Arabella. You had your holiday romance.
No, she had a zolliday romance. On the last night of the holiday, I walked past Stephen and Joss's room and heard them say good night. It was the sweetest thing I've ever heard. I felt like the father of happy little twins.
Buonanotte, Stefano.
Buonanotte, Josso.
On the final day of the holiday, we gathered by my front doormat to say our goodbyes.
Oh, I had a lovely time, Richard. Thank you. I feel so relaxed.
Good. I'm so sorry your boy never got his postcard.
No, no, he did. I told Roberto what to write and he sent it.
Forced your signature, then?
Yeah, but it's only Dad. No one can read my handwriting anyway.
Excellent. Arabella.
Oh, Richard, it was great.
It was, and now it's over.
I hate the end of a holiday.
Me too.
Yeah.
Oh, well. And so we return to real life.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
See you.
See you. Ciao.
I haven't thanked you. It was wonderful.
Stick around a moment.
So?
So?
What's this then? A holiday reunion?
That's just it. I haven't had a holiday, have I? I've had three people to stay for a week. That's not a holiday, is it?
No, I suppose not. You felt responsible for their happiness.
Exactly.
So what are you saying then?
What about France? Greece? Italy? All three.
Oh, I'm tired just thinking about it.
Yes. All those bloody airports.
Why not come to mine for the weekend? I've got a spare room.
A holiday in Waterloo.
Why not? There's a river. And I live near a Greggs.
You're on. In Believe It, Richard Wilson, Jos Vantyler, Stephen Mangan and Arabella Weir played themselves. And Bert Seymour was Roberto. It was written by Jon Canter and produced and directed by Clive Brill. Believe It is a Brill production for BBC Radio 4. Wish you were here, but you're there. And for that, thank you. Arrivederci.